So, a little thought went through my mind. Hey, that's the ticket. I can speak about myself. And then I started thinking more, and that's a problem for me sometimes, because I started thinking from a perspective of philosophy and psychology, and that's a very heavy question. Who am I? I'm going to speak about myself, and then I'm going to tell you, well, my name is Jean-Pierre Scatelon, and yeah, that is a beautiful name, but it tells you nothing about me. I was born in Peru, and I grew up in the States. That may give you an idea of who I am, but still tells you very little about me. When I was young, around the age of 5, I could speak in Spanish, and we had a patio with a gate, and about this gap from the ground, there was a gate with a few little bars, and I used to go down there, and I used to say, hola. Hola, to all the passersby. Hola means hello in Spanish. And as I got a little older, I used to approach people by, hi, hi. And, well, that was also my teenager, so I was a little bit. Myself, sometimes I share a little too much, and I open myself a little too much. But that is myself of my natural way of trying to connect with people. The power of connection is very important. It's one of the, in psychology, it's one of the human needs. We want to connect with people. And the best way to connect with people is by allowing people to not only look at you, but to see you. To see here. That requires vulnerability. So I'll tell you a little bit more about me so you can get an idea of who I am. It's very hard to say who a person is, because I believe that we are a summation of different events that happen to you. So I'll tell you something that happened to me. In the summer of 2010, I was living in the mountains of Afghanistan. I was there with a small group of friends, and we had weapons, we had ammunition, we had explosives, and we were confident. Even to the degree of cockiness. Yeah, I was a US soldier. I thought I was trained for everything. Except, I was not trained to see small children get hurt. On one given day, 3 small children came across an IED. That is an explosive, improvised explosive device. It was meant for us. But somehow, they had triggered it, and they were severely hurt. Soon enough, they were brought to us, and as I stood there, providing security for the medics with my weapon, I realized they were 3 small bodies. I looked down, expecting to see the faces of 3 small children. And something happened to me. My brain did something to me at the time for some reason. I expected to see 3 small faces of Afghani children. And instead, I saw the faces, the reflection of the faces of my 3 small children. At that time, something just came undone inside. My face was covered with tears, but at the same time, I was washed over by a feeling of numbness. This numbness became a part of me for months and even years after that. In the context of war, numbness is useful. It becomes like a superpower. When you're not able to feel very much, you can do anything. You're unstoppable. But when you come home and you are numb, you create this barrier, and those people who want to love you cannot come through. And within a short amount of time, a lot of my close relationships became injured. Luckily, enough people saw what was going on, pointed me in the right direction, and I was able to get help. I was diagnosed and treated for PTSD, post-traumatic stress disorder. And within time, I was able to heal those wounds inside of me and began to connect with people once again. Yes, many years ago I was a soldier, and today, after everything that I've gone through, I remain a warrior, but a warrior in the way that one of the great philosophers said, I am a warrior, but I'm a peaceful warrior because the battles that we fight are inside of us. And today, here I am once again. I have become part of a team, learning new skills, mastering new skills that will allow me to become confident once again. So I can, once again, continue to connect with people, continue to build relationships. And that is, in part, a little bit of who I am. I am somebody who wants to build relationships, somebody who doesn't want to use violence, but somebody who wants to use connection to be a better person. And that is one of the reasons why I'm here. Thank you, Mr. Tucker.